Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This is Abdul Basit Sohail from Lahore, Pakistan. Today we shall discuss about contract of Salam. Salam means to advance. Salam is a contract where buyer pays full price in advance. This is the main condition for Salam, that buyer should pay full amount of transaction in advance to the seller. And the delivery of subject matter and the delivery of that commodity is postponed to a specified future date. We can understand Salam contract with example. Suppose a buyer wants 500 kg and the price of 500 kg is supposed 1000 rupees. So the buyer has to pay 10,000 rupees in advance and seller will provide 500 kg after 2 or 3 months when he will harvest the wheat or rice. So such kind of contract is Salam contract. Salam was present before the migration of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam towards Medina. So some companions of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam presented this contract in front of Prophet for guidance purpose. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam changed some conditions of Salam and permitted this transaction. So here is the main principle. Here is the some general rules for validity of a sale. For a valid sale, the possession of the commodity should be present in the possession of seller. This is a general condition. Without the possession and ownership and existence of the subject matter, that seller cannot sell his commodity to another. But there are two exemptions to this main rule. What are those exemptions? Number one, Salam contract that we described few moments ago. So second exceptions is istisna contract. Istisna is the contract of manufacturing, where we give an order to the manufacturer to make certain goods according to given description. So this is called istisna. So Salam and istisna are two exceptions to this main principle. So the Salam is extendable contract. Jurists have not confined Salam to those agriculture products only, but have expanded the list of Salamable items to all the commodities that could be determined in terms of quality and quantity. So we should keep in mind, Salam is allowed for the commodities that can be easily determined in terms of quality and quantity. Salam of all those commodities are permissible that can be determined in quality and quantity. So these are some conditions for valid Salam. It's necessary to fix a period for delivery of goods to avoid any confusion or uncertainty between buyer and supplier, seller, that the period for the delivery of the goods should be fixed. And as we described earlier, payment should be in advance, can be determined by quality and quantity. So outstanding loan due on the seller can't be fully or partially fixed as price, nor for future adjustment. So mean that the price of Salam should be separate rather than adjusting loan towards seller. The main condition also, object of Salam should be defined by description. It requires minute description to avoid any vagueness and uncertainty between buyer and seller. So salam can be revoked in case of the death of a seller. Salam will be deemed to be rescinded and buyer can claim money from legal heirs. In case of death of the buyer, salam will be operative. Islamic banks and financial institutions use salam as mode of financing. Our reference book was Islamic Law of Contract and Business Transactions by Dr. Tahir Mansouri. May Allah forgive my mistakes in content and concept. Thank you.